you know, we've talked about sort of the big issue of the environment. We're now talking about the county level and how that affects things. And now we're going to take one level further. We're going down to the local level. And we're going to talk a little bit about the committee work that is very, very important in determining the direction of your municipality. So I'd like to introduce Anna Evans, who is the chair of the Hainesport Democrats. Now, Anna has quite an interesting background. She actually was born and raised in England and moved to Burlington County in 2000 and became a U.S. citizen in 2009.
Wow.
Yeah. But she embraced her Americanism. She ran for township committee as a Democrat in 2016 and 2017, losing twice to the Republican in the Republican-controlled township of Hainesport, which has not elected a Democrat since the early 1990s. But she didn't give up. She became chair of the Hainesport Democrats in January of 2018. And has now been working with her committee people to try to make some progress in Hainesport. But she has life beyond politics. She's also a published poet and essayist. She teaches writing Burlington County, and poetry at West Windsor Art Center. And her political letters, Barbara was happy to know, are frequently published in the Burlington County Times and elsewhere. So let us welcome Anna. Now, Anna, you're going to get interrupted here about one minute by an announcement.
All right, so you're ready to get into weeds? Okay. I want to introduce Hainesport just a little bit so it makes sense. So you have to understand that this is how Republican Hainesport is. We already passed that ridiculous resolution against the green tax. We already did that. I don't know if anyone read the articles in the Burlington County Times about the anti-sanctuary law.
Yes.
That was Hainesport. We also have one of the candidates for the Republican freeholder position is from Hainesport, and Ryan Peters, the assemblyman, is from Hainesport. That's how Republican we are. So that's what I'm up against on a daily basis. This is Hainesport. Now, I'm going to introduce you to some of the tools of the trade as a municipal chair. This is the map of our districts. Every township in Burlington County is divided into districts. And this is what your county committee is based upon. Hainesport has 5 districts. You can see them there outlined in red. And each district is represented at the county committee level by 1 male and 1 female committee person. And the interesting thing about these districts is that, particularly in Hainesport, they are very unique. They are different. I like to say that Hainesport is a microcosm of America, right? We've got our affordable housing. We've got our active senior community. We've got our old part of Hainesport, where people have lived there for generations. We've got our new developments, where people have just moved in. You know, so we've got all this stuff. So it's really important that every district gets good representation from people who know them. And that means people who live in those districts. So here's my other tool of the trade. Every municipal chair will have one of these. This is the voter roll in Hainesport. This is a listing of every person who is registered to vote in Hainesport. And it is up to date as of October 2018. So it's pretty up to date. And on this, I have everybody's name, everybody's address, and everybody's voter affiliation. So I know who the Democrats are in Hainesport. I know where they are. I can knock on their doors. When I became chair in January of last year, my committee was at half strength. That means I had 5 of the 10 committee members that I needed. And I can't emphasize to you how important it is to fill those slots, because these are the people who live in those districts. They can make sure that those districts' needs are listened to. They can act as a bridge between those people and the higher-ups, if you like. So in January 2018, I had no District 1 reps. I had 2 in District 2. I had 2 in District 3, a married couple. I had none in District 4, and I had 1 in District 5. So what do you do? Right, several things. Persuasion. If you know some people in those districts personally, you go and talk to them. I recruited two females that way. I just said, come on, what are you doing? You're a Democrat. One of them was marching at the Women's March with me, right? And I'm like, well, if you can march at the Women's March, you can be a committee rep. It's a low-profile role. This is important to some people. You know, they don't, I stick my head above the parapet all the time and I get shocked. But my county committee people don't have to do that. It's a low-profile role. It's very important. So, persuasion, direct request. I texted and messaged some male Democrats that I know and said, come on, you can do this. It's not hard. I filled two slots that way. And finally, my fifth and final empty slot, I went door knocking. I knocked on the doors of every likely looking male Democrat in District 1. And one of them answered the door and said, okay, that's something I can do. And it was fantastic because he is one of the people who lives in my affordable housing community. So finally, I have a way into that community, which is full of Democrats who don't vote. Right? They don't vote in Hainesport because they don't see the point. So this is why it's really important to keep doing this. Unfortunately, vacancies keep arising, and you just keep filling them. My district, one female moved out of district. I already have a replacement for her. She popped up on Hainesport happenings in support of Democratic views, and I text messaged her. I said, what district of Hainesport do you live in? She said, District 1. I said, I love you. Yeah. So that's that. Okay, so the concept that we have to work with is really that of the precinct captain. It's not a name that we use, but that's kind of what we're doing. Everybody who is a committee rep in their district needs to get to know the people on this in their district. They need to have a copy of this, go through it, see who they already know. They know more people than they think they know, right? And if they don't know them, go and find a way to know them, knock on their doors. Like, get to know them, find out their email addresses, talk to them, find out what they think about what's going on in Hainesport. Become known as a resource that they can go to. You, as a county committee rep, you are effectively the voice of that district, right? So it's really important to get them involved. Encourage the Democrats in your district to follow the Facebook page, right? To know where the website is, to get their email addresses so that you can add them to your email database. I have an email database of about 150 registered Democrats in Hainesport. I may not sound like a lot, but there's only 4,000 voters in Hainesport. So it's actually more than you think. And these are people who now put out lawn signs. These are people who we can rely upon to vote. We can email them and say, you must remember there's an election tomorrow, you've got to come. And the important thing is that this work should be happening not just around the election. It should be happening year-round. We've got to build it from the ground up. We've got to form communities of people who know that if they do this, they can make a difference. Even in a ruby-red town like Hainesport, right? So I now have a full slate of committee reps. I have people who talk to their neighbors. I have more lawn signs going out there than ever. Will it make a difference in Hainesport this year? Probably not. But that's what we got to keep doing. And the final thing I want to leave you with is the problem you have is that sometimes the people who want to get involved are in districts where you already have committee reps. That happens a lot in Hainesport because we've got this really large district called District 3, which has most of our voters. It's got 1,206 of our voters, right? So, and 497 of them are Democrats, and so they want to get involved, but there's no slot for them on the county committee. That shouldn't be a barrier. The more people we can get involved at this level, the merrier. Right? Everyone in a district knows different people. District 3 consists really of three distinct areas in its own right. It would be great to have somebody involved from each of those areas within the district. And you also need those people who can be replacements so that when you lose someone, you can push someone else in straight away, and that way you never run on half empty like we were when I took over. And just as a good point, right now in Hainesport, I'm not on the county committee. I'm not, I mean, I get some form of voting rights there because I'm the chair, but I am not officially a Burlington County Committee rep. I am the chair. The two people who represent my district, the husband and wife team in District 3, have no interest in being anything other than the county committee people. But they're great at what they do, but I can still be involved. And the same way, the secretary of the Hainesport Democrats is also not a county committee rep. She was. She's the one who moved out of district in District 1. But she was like, please, I want to stay involved. I want to keep being involved in the Democrats Club of Hainesport. So it's the more the merrier. Bring everyone in, get everyone to volunteer, form subcommittees, make sure everyone has a role of some kind, and just let's get out there and do what we can this year and every year to keep flipping Burlington County Townships and Burlington County Freeholder Boards and Legislative District 8 and all the way.